I'm not exaggerating the magnitude of this verdict. This really is the biggest test of India's secular fabric in its history. There is a view that this judgment prioritized faith over facts. That's an opinion, as exemplified by the comments of Asaduddin Owaisi. But truth be told, the preamble of the Constitution underlines the need to protect the liberty of thought, expression, and note this, belief, faith, and worship. On Wion Edit, we explore the significance of today's verdict. And let me make it absolutely clear that this is not the first time that faith has been accommodated in India's courts. And why just the courts? Governments too have also accommodated faith in the past. During the first term of the UPA, the government withdrew an affidavit that mentioned Ram as a mythological figure. Remember that time? This was in retaliation to the Setu Samudram shipping project. This project would have brought down the Ram Setu, which is believed to be the bridge built by Lord Ram to cross the Indian Ocean and go to Sri Lanka. But then again, it was the government changing its position on a matter that involved faith, not the courts. As far as this verdict is concerned, the impartiality of the Supreme Court is evident. India's Place of Worship Act clearly draws the line. It says that protection of equality of all faiths is an essential constitutional value. Today's judgment acknowledges that. I had said that this is a litmus test for India's secularism, and that is because of the polarization in Indian society since the fateful events of December 6, 1992. The Supreme Court came down hard on that. The order also spoke about secularism. Page 223 notes, and I'm quoting, secularism, listen to this carefully, secularism cannot be a writ lost in the sands of time by being oblivious to the exercise of religious freedom by everyone. Very important words. Secularism, which has been derided as appeasement politics by some and hailed as the core component of Indian democracy by others, the Supreme Court today did not mince any words, and the citizens of this country must follow the lead of its court. India is a secular country. Everyone in India has a right to practice and propagate their religion. Diversity of all kinds is the bedrock of Indian social life. It is great that there was absolute harmony on the ground today, but this needs to be continued in the coming times. This should be the norm. This verdict was complicated because this issue is complex. In fact, the matter was decided legally. It had to go to the courts because other attempts at resolution failed. Now it's time to let peace prevail in Ayodhya and elsewhere in this country. It is time for all of us to accept, acknowledge, and uphold the freedom of the entire country to practice their faith without fear. Political parties must refrain from seeking gains out of this verdict. They must contest elections now on existential issues and not historical ones. It is time to uphold the character of India, the idea of India.